Good morning. I'm Trang Do with your morning digital news brief for Tuesday, July 30th. The search is on for three suspects who robbed a Chipotle in Northeast Philadelphia. The armed robbery happened just before 10 last night at the Roosevelt Mall on Cottman Avenue. Police say three masked men stormed the back entrance of the store while employees and customers were inside. No one was hurt. Dozens delivered a message that it is time to stop the violence in Atlantic City. An estimated 75 people gathered at New Shiloh Baptist Church for a prayer vigil yesterday evening. They then marched several blocks on Delaware Avenue. Last week, a 15-year-old girl was found shot to death in a vacant apartment there. And a South Jersey couple is helping others get back on their feet. Last month, Patrick Reardon and Susan Cook bought out the entire Payless store in the Hamilton Township Marketplace in Mercer County. Every item was on sale for just a dollar. They only spent $250. The shoes went to Women's Space, a shelter and rehabilitation program in Lawrenceville. Now let's check eyewitness weather. Here's meteorologist Katie Fallinger.
Hey there, Trang. Well, it's a very warm, very muggy day. This is the last really hot day before the temperature starts to scale back a little bit here, and that's because we've got a frontal boundary that'll eventually be crossing through. But for now, it's definitely still just steamy. So expect that you're going to see more sun than anything today. There will, however, be a very spotty PM thunderstorm. Now, that is primarily going to occur, I'd say, no earlier than 2 p.m., and especially true for the north and western counties. Now, the other thing to keep in mind is that most of you will, in fact, stay dry. We use that term loosely because it is so steamy outside. The dew points are quite high, at least in the upper 60s. Now, by tomorrow, that cold front is crossing through. It's not a wash of a day, but there will be a more organized round of showers and storms. And that's what, again, is going to be responsible for the temperatures getting scaled back to more seasonable territory for Friday and Saturday especially. But that front looks like it might try to hang nearby for a couple of days. So that's why we've got to allow for a shower or a thunderstorm Friday or Saturday at this point. Trey?
Thanks, Katie. Remember, you can always get Katie's most up-to-date forecast and the latest stories right here on CBSPhilly.com. That's the latest for the morning digital brief. I'm Trang Do. Good morning.